In this video, I want to tell you the truth about cataract surgery, intraocular lenses, and your visual outcomes after the surgery. Hi there, my name is Alexey, and you're at IOL-adviser Eye Surgery Explained channel, telling the truth about intraocular lenses. I've been working in ophthalmic surgery field for more than 26 years, and honestly, I've gathered a lot of experience talking with the patients, talking with the customers, with the surgeons, and now working as an independent consultant in this field, I want to summarize my experience about the unsatisfactory outcomes, about the great outcomes with different IOL types, with different expectations of the patients. And let me explain you three main misconceptions and three, let's say, problematic points related to intraocular lenses or IOLs and visual outcomes after cataract surgery or refractive lens exchange. The first one. We do not have any perfect IOL of all the ages which will perfectly suit to every single patient. So, other words, we do not have any perfect IOL at all. But we do have a perfect marketing. The perfect marketing makes any IOL which you look at a perfect choice, especially for you. Because marketing works in this way that we always highlight something good, and we never talk about some, let's say, drawbacks or limitations. Or we highlight something good in bright, strong, bold words. And if sometimes we're talking about compromises, we talk about compromises very, let's say, quiet, shy, and try to not emphasize on that. So it creates sometimes our expectations, extra expectation after the cataract surgery about the visual outcomes with the IOL. What are the visual outcomes that patients expect after the cataract surgery? It depends if we're talking about cataract surgery or refractive lens exchange. Generally, if we're talking about cataract surgery, the patients normally are so affected by cataract, so annoyed by this foggy media. So the first impression after any IOL implanted is, wow, I see clearly, doctor, thank you so much, I'm so happy, etc. Because you wait for such a time before your surgery and the first impression is great. But at the end of the day, if you ask any patient about how you would like to see after the surgery, the answer will be, well, I want to see clearly at all the distances. And honestly, we even not quite often thinking about the distances, because if you are young and healthy and our eyes constructed by nature in, let's say, without any refractive disorders, we do have sharp vision at far, and we have sharp vision at near, intermediate, etc. So at any distance where we put our eyes on. And it is due to the accommodation mechanism. When our eye is adjusted to the focal distance where we are looking to, it's performed absolutely automatically. We never think about that, but you used to have the great vision, even if you have to use the glasses for far vision because of accommodation. And the problem is that any intraocular lens doesn't have accommodation. Despite we do have some commercially available or at pre-release stage accommodative lenses, they are not able to restore the full accommodation at all. And that's why we normally use pseudo-accommodation. So despite the lens is flexible, it is not able to accommodate. And the highest expectation, the majority of expectations after the cataract surgery is to be spectacle independent at far, intermediate, and near, depending on intraocular lens type. And when it comes to the problem after the cataract surgery, we have two types of problem. The first one is kind of medical issues related to other comorbidities like glaucoma, traumas, retinal diseases, macular degeneration, diabetes. So let's exclude it from the equation. I'm talking about other type of refractive disorders, about the other type of problems with the intraocular lenses when the patient was expected to be spectacle independent or was expected to see clearly at far or at near. And after the surgery, the patient has a very bad visual outcomes. What does it mean? Bad visual outcomes, I'm talking about the bad visual acuity or bad visual quality in dim light conditions, is a general problems with the intraocular lenses. And honestly, it's never related to IOL itself. Let me explain. When I'm talking, it's not related to IOL itself. I'm talking about that if the intraocular lens is properly selected for particular patient, for particular patient's need and needs and expectations, and we exclude all the marketing, let's say, bullshit from the equation, and we know what really to expect from the lens. And if the lens is calculated properly for the particular eye in terms of its refractive power, and it has been implanted in the right position, and there is no any, let's say, traumas, no any complications during the surgery, the every lens always perform the same way as it is designed. There is no way that one lens performs good for one patient and same model performs bad for a second patient because of lens. It is always because of surgical technique. It is always because of misconception or misunderstanding of the doctor or the technologist, or extra expectation of the patient after the surgery. What is extra expectations? Expectations of visual acuity at different distances. And what is the problematic point here? The problematic point here is a surgeon to patient discussion, or technician or counselor to patient discussion. Because during this type of discussions, no one never clearly explains to the patients all the details. Normally, the discussion ends up well, you will see clearly here, here, and there. That's it. So you will be able to read. Done. Would you like to be able to read without glasses? Yes, I am. It is a lens for you. It will allow you to read without glasses. Fine. Contract signed. Money paid. Gone. And the problem is that different people have a different visual needs, a different expectation. Different people have different visual experience before the surgery and different visual experience after the surgery. And if we are talking about the experience after the surgery with trifocal or monofocal lens, the quality of vision, the experience of vision is absolutely different. Moreover, different lenses by design are not able to provide 100% of sharp vision to the far. For example, we have Lucidis IOL, which is supposed to be presbyopia correcting, which is supposed to deliver all the good vision across the range. And it does, but it never gives you more than 9 lines. So for somebody, 9 lines is more than enough. For somebody, 9 lines is a nightmare, because before the surgery, patient was able to see 12 lines. Talking about marketing, it's extremely important to understand how to read the marketing claims, how to read the articles, how to read the even scientific publication, because our marketing in the industry is in many cases are leaded or done through the scientific publications. And different scientific publications might have a different quality. Sometimes data might be selected in a proper way, in a special way to, let's say, to deliver such results, etc. So honestly, it's quite complicated industry. When I was young and just started my career in this field, I was working maybe 3 years in the industry. I was working in an IOL company, which later acquired another IOL company. And before this acquisition, we've been a competitors. And before I've been on industry, let's say commercial training and clinical application training in my original company. And then I've been in the same training in the new company because I was supposed to work with different IOLs. And interestingly, the marketing and clinical application explained some advantages of, let's say, our first lenses, like a big advantages, and emphasized on disadvantages of competitor. But when I switched to another room, it turned opposite. Advantages became disadvantages, and disadvantages became advantages. So honestly, in the modern world, it's very important how you explain nature of something. It sometimes can change the true story. So how to avoid the trap if you are a patient and your surgeon will tell you that, well, you are absolutely eligible for any type of IOLs. I have 4 options for you. Do your choice. Or if you are not sure about the selection and your surgeon emphasized on one particular IOL because it's the best of the best for your particular case, what to do in this case? To help you to take a really informative decision together with the surgeon, to help you to eliminate the marketing, let's say, cover out of the lens, to help you to understand your visual needs better, to understand limitations and cons and pros of different lenses and limitations of the technologies, I have created a dedicated website called IOLadviser.com. The link will be in the description below, which will help you to understand your visual needs through the automated questionnaire, which you may pass through, then take the result of this IOL questionnaire with you to your surgeon and discuss your visual needs based on that questionnaire. And if you are still in doubt about IOL selection process, or you have some problems after the surgery and you don't know how to discuss with your surgeon that case, I'm here to help. I'm not interested in selling you any IOLs. I'm not interested in selling you any surgery. I'm just an independent industry expert who will help you to understand intraocular lenses, your visual options, what might be wrong with the optics, and I will prepare you for discussion with your doctor to be focused on what is important, what is less important, and let's say how to find the common language, how to find the common points of discussion with your doctor to get the best visual outcomes after the cataract surgery. Okay, let's come back to the topic. Any presbyopia corrective lens which allows you to read will never give you, let's say, 100% of vision at near. To obtain 100% of vision at near, we have to use different techniques. And generally, this misunderstanding between surgeon and patient leads to unsatisfactory results. So the truth is, the first one, we don't have any perfect lens at all. And every lens has some limitations, some drawbacks. And to be happy after the surgery, you have to understand what exactly you expect after the surgery with your visual outcomes. What limitations any lens you select might provide you and what it really realistic and it can give you. Second, if the lens is supposed to deliver something realistically and it is not delivered, in majority of cases, it is either, let's say, lens selected wrongly for particular patient's cornea or particular patient's retina or something like that, or in majority of cases, it is a refractive shift. It is a refractive error which can be improved by putting contact lenses, glasses, or additional laser vision correction, which is not good, but it is a solution. And the third truth is that discussion about good or bad vision at certain distances or general feeling of good or bad vision with a certain IOL shall be done in a more detailed way. It shall not be stopped at the point, so I'm willing to read, I'm willing to, let's say, drive without glasses. It should be more detailed, more deep about the visual outcomes, about the visual acuity, or at least some examples. So, for instance, patient may say, well, I want to do something tiny without glasses. It's extremely important for me. Or patient shall say, well, my far vision is extremely important for me. I need the best resolution. I need the best visual outcomes. And for patient and for surgeon at this point, it's important to accept that and understand. So maybe that particular patient, despite he is ready to pay for premium lens, he is ready to pay for a trifocal or EDOF, he is not the best candidate because the most important for that patient is a far vision. And one more advice for patients and the surgeons as well. When we are talking about what is important for patient, we always have a tendency to focus on where your, let's say, life concentrated. For instance, we have a general idea that if a patient is office worker or reads a lot, this patient and spends a lot of time in the office reading or working on a computer, talking with the people, etc., that patient is a great candidate for trifocal lenses if he or she wants to be spectacle independent. And vice versa, for instance, if a patient, hunter or, doing a lot of sports, outdoor activities, generally that patient is a great candidate for EDOF lens. It's easy and clear, but the very important point which we miss here, we focus on time spent at certain locations, but we never pay attention to the question is what is important for the person. For instance, talking about that office worker who spends 8 hours a day working with near objects, we might forget and we never think about that it might be something in his or her life which really brings the life to his life. It might be, hiking, running, alpinism, hunting, yachting, whatever. And that type of activity might require extremely sharp far vision. And it brings so much fun, so much life, so much energy, and it's so much important for the life of that person. That person will be absolutely unhappy with a trifocal lens which allows him or her to be spectacle free 8 hours, but it will limit far vision ability for the hobby, for something which brings life, for something which brings life enjoyment, brings energy, and something what that person really enjoys to be happy. And probably for that particular person, it would be great to sit in front of the computer 8 hours a day with the glasses to work, and then spend, let's say, 2 hours a day or spend 2 weeks of the vacation without glasses to enjoy the life. So all these points are absolutely important to understand and to take into equation. So all these points are absolutely important and has to be considered and taken into equation to get the best visual outcomes after the cataract surgery. It is the truth.